Your presence always implied a superior knowledge. Your fat body always dominating the room. Your sexual manipulations always transparent. I remember your death, memory suppression, fragmented images, and insane emotions. Your body had been lying for about 3 days before I walked into your room. Interchange of characters and locations, the fractured timeline and details changed. Preferred. You were naked and younger than I remembered you. Your face was wrapped in cling film, lips forced wide, eyes open, refusing to follow me as I moved about your body to his room. It had taken a long time to come to terms with the impact of your disappearance. The opium haze, the alcoholic numbness, the compared face of a perished. I cut your hair as you lay as if waiting for me to cut my fingers and wake you from your daydream. I dreamt you. I dress you. with so many things. Your difficult manner is the least of concerns. I have wasted so much time listening to people who offer me nothing. Politeness is not a virtue in the penthouse or in this, and yet I have failed. Good friends, good lovers who deserve so much better. And you, the sweet growth, your abused wife, deaf. Destroy your mother. story. Thank you.
Thank you.
those you know best. Your fear creating a hollow, transparent bubble of life. You are and will always be sick, a sick acceptor. Kicking against nothing but your own failings, there is always something missing. Fixed, endearing image of man. Always careful, always slow and deliberate. Taking care around the eyes, not too much, not too little. Lips exaggerated slightly. The transformation is not an aesthetic improvement, but a mask. The clothing is chosen as uniform. The girls will talk and the boys will stare, but what she does know is that the boy who gets in her car with her later was beaten by his mother just 3 hours earlier, and she did not know that he had burns across his back and legs, that he had bruises about his face, covered by makeup, that he had spent the night locked in a filthy coal bunker sobbing all night. She also did not know that his mother had broken his arm when he was 3, that he jumped when she spoke, and that he was desperate to please her, that he pissed the bed. The first punch took her completely by surprise, knocking her head against the car window. But her neck spinning. Her bear fell to the floor beside the seats. She instinctively started to pick up the lipstick, keys, tissues, cotton wool and makeup. The mirror, all from the floor between her knees. Not daring to look up, the pain in her cheekbone was intense, but she tried to ignore it and carry on as if nothing had happened. A second punch knocked her almost unconscious. This time, it was in the temple. Head bouncing off against the door as she leaned down to pick up the packet of mints from between new highs and new shoes, he shouted out as if he were in pain. No, she didn't. But what he never knew was that this was pornography. She wondered if he remembered. She wondered if he knew that she had chosen him sometime. She wondered how he could be so stupid. He had not been to a man back asleep. He had not seen the man sitting on the back of the door with the camera. He had not seen the man at the back of the door, both filming every spotted body part and line of his eyes, his cheek, his nose, and part of his jaw. He would spend the rest of his life without a face. This is the pornography.
Oh.